Hey, welcome to Film Fury. I'm Victor Lucas. This is Johnny Millennium, and we are reviewing American Assassin. But first, we have to thank our friends at the VFS School of Film. All right, let's get right to this. American Assassin stars Michael Keaton, who's making a big, ferocious comeback, Dylan O'Brien, and Taylor Kitsch, who I am now going to deem the unlucky rabbit's foot in a lot of movies, because every time he appears in a movie...
What are you saying? Well, how dare you? This is my movie of the year, and you're just going to give it the old thumbs down?
I gave it the thumbs down plus fart sound.
We have to cut to B-roll so nobody knows what's going on there.
Yeah.
You know, honestly, this sounds so bad to say, and I don't, you know, we go into movies to enjoy them,
yeah,
not to bash them, you know.
Yes.
But this one is a bash fest, folks. We were in a screening for 8 people of this movie,
yeah,
and 2 of them walked out.
Yeah.
What does that say about this movie? In fact...
Well, they made it through the bulk of the film, but then they parachuted off of this disaster. I've had enough.
My favorite bit in this movie, and this is no joke, was when I went to take a piss.
Yeah.
I went and I was like, hallelujah.
You should have been rolling on that. Why weren't you rolling on that? That would have been a better 2 hours than this.
It doesn't take
them 2 hours to take
no,
a piss.
No, it doesn't. I wish it did, though, for this movie.
I give your piss an 8 out of 10, by the way.
what did you dislike about this movie?
This movie actually has a pretty, you know, topical premise of a terrorist attack on a beach that leads an American who watches somebody he loves die into this kind of journey of revenge. And unfortunately, it just gets fast-tracked to suddenly he becomes this operative who is getting trained by Michael Keaton. And like, it feels like within a week, he is like back in the field.
A week? I think it was like 2 days.
Well, yeah, it's ridiculous.
They do some rolling around on the ground and they're ready to go.
Yeah, rolling around the ground, then he's off and he's in charge of a pretty, you know, big mission. There are nukes in
play. It doesn't get any bigger than that.
And he's got to go and stop everything. And it's not only just him, it's like the other rookie. They're both put in charge. Like, okay, you guys, you had this special secret op, and if you die, no one's coming to get you. And, you know, Michael Keaton has to grit and his teeth, and he's just like, he's got to be all macho. He sucks in his 65-year-old gut. Looks pretty good. Let's be honest.
Yeah. We love Michael Keaton.
Yes.
He's fantastic. He's a great actor.
Yeah.
So the problem is not with Michael Keaton.
No.
The problem is with the script.
It's the script, man. 100%. It is just
But it's the
junk.
Direction, and you're going to try to defend the direction.
Well,
you cannot defend it.
I think that the movie has a look to it that I didn't mind.
That's the cinematography.
Yeah, cinematography and kind of the aesthetic of the film. Obviously, they're aping a lot of what Doug Liman kind of pioneered and engineered for us with The Bourne Identity. That movie is seminal, and it gets referenced over and over. It changed the Bond movies, let's be honest, right? That is a fantastic film.
It is, absolutely.
The first Bourne is just, it's a pinnacle. It's a fantastic film that kind of changed the idea of espionage and all kinds of stuff. The problem with this is that it just looks like it's the Coles notes of all that. It doesn't look like the
it's
sets.
It's not innovating. It's not innovating anything.
It looks like an echo chamber, and it looks like a mirror of some of the stuff. Like, they set up all of these monitors inside of the tactical ops room, and it just looks, and then they've got all these glowy lights and light strips to make it look super high-tech and cool.
And they're monitoring him.
And everybody's got the, you know, super serious face. And it's like, let me ask you this. Like, if you are in like a crime-ridden area or area where there might be terrorist kind of activity, and everybody gets out of black cars with surly faces, don't they kind of stand out? Like, are people just, like, if they're that miserable, aren't you going to zero in on everybody trying to be tough guy and super
tough
cool?
Tough guy, you know, the guns in there.
Yeah,
you know,
and black coach. And,
yeah.
Like, it's
so odd.
Yeah.
This movie is a disaster on so many levels.
Yes.
We could spend 2 hours dissecting how this went wrong. And how did it go wrong?
Yeah.
I mean, like, the main actor, I'm sorry.
It's Dylan O'Brien.
Dylan O'Brien.
I like him.
I don't care.
I like him.
Much.
He surprised me in the Maze Runner movies. I've seen, I don't know, more than I want to see of those movies, but I've seen him. And he was actually pretty good in that. He got into that horrific accident. I don't know if you remember. They were shooting in Vancouver. He almost died.
Oh, that's terrible. I didn't know that.
And so he's come back, and he's got a vitality. He's got a strength. And I think they're trying to bank on this guy to be part of a franchise, but this movie is so god-awful. No way.
I liked American Ninja back in the day more than I liked American Assassin. It's just so dumb. All of a sudden, He's just this incredible assassin, killing everybody and destroying everything, and then rescuing everybody from like a nuclear explosion.
Except that he has to face Michael Keaton's former protege, played by Taylor Kitsch, who's like a mirror image of Dylan O'Brien, just a little older, a little more grizzled, more scars on his body. And
he shows you all the scars. Look at all my scars.
And he's got all of these ridiculous, just on the nose kinds of lines in this thing. He's just, he hates America and they left me for dead. You left me behind. And
it's so generic, all of it.
It is, all of it.
We've seen this so much before.
Even Keaton, like, he's just
doing the same thing.
He's churning the sausage, man. Like, we have seen this stuff a million times. The grizzled old guy that's got all the wisdom.
I'll show you everything.
He's going to beat it into his students.
I know. I got a headache from this movie after a while.
It was dumb, man.
I was just waiting. There's one scene where they're fighting, and the next scene they're on a boat. I swear to God, this is what happened. I'm like, okay, they're fighting. I get a text. I go like this. I look at my text. I look back. They're on a boat fighting.
See, and I'm like, what never the? Never look at your text in a movie.
No, and
never
I agree, or you might miss something incredible.
You might be on a boat when you come back up.
You might be on a boat. Yeah. I was waiting for that boat to crash and end and let me off.
The end of this movie is just hysterically over the top. It's like so some of all fears. If anybody saw that terrible Ben Affleck, Tom Clancy movie that got to the zenith of idiocy, we're in that area again here with this movie, and it's insulting, and it's so manipulative as well. You can feel like Dylan O'Brien was cast as a young guy. He probably got a couple $1 million paycheck, and he took the deal, and he's like, I'm going to be playing against Michael Keaton. Taylor Kitsch has been in a lot of movies. Maybe this will be the good one that he's in.
It sounds good on paper. I bet the story looked good on paper. With the right direction, they could have pulled it off.
But
it's the director.
It feels like propaganda. Like, I'm watching this thing, and it just feels
That's bad propaganda. That's my problem.
There's an element of like selling the story and the mystery and the mystique of joining this
propaganda
this kind
movie,
of world.
Top Gun.
Yeah.
When me and my sister, when me and my sister came out of Top Gun, my sister became a pilot.
Right. That's amazing.
That's good. Yeah. This just makes me want to jump off a boat.
Doesn't make you want to be an assassin.
No, I want to blow myself up with a nuclear missile so I don't have to see this movie again.
How about if we become assassins of bad writers in Hollywood?
You know, the thing is please save your money.
Yeah.
Like, even if this is on Netflix, which it will be in 2 months,
it looks,
don't watch it.
It looks it looks like a movie Netflix passed on.
Yeah.
Right? It looks like, no.
No,
that's not good
enough.
I can't
believe they got Michael Keaton onto this. He's like, I get to be this grizzly guy and be grizzly. And it's no, it just didn't pull off.
I'm kind of wondering when this was shot, you know, because maybe this was done before Spider-Man and before Dylan O'Brien got in the accident.
We'll have to do some research. I don't know the answer.
Yeah, I don't know, but it's total. It's
trash.
It's trash. It's lunacy. It doesn't make sense. It's kind of insulting. You know, the action beats play with an air of authenticity and some fun, but it's the mind-numbing stupid you have to kind of sit through before you're in these moments of, you know, some kinetic activity that's somewhat enjoyable. I actually thought the opening beach sequence was effective, and I thought
to establish the revenge again.
Yeah, and I thought that was an effective part of the trailers and the marketing for this. I mean, you can cut pieces, and you'll see these trailers. I mean, that's what we're cutting our review to. It looks like it will be thrilling and exciting.
Let me say something. You always knew whenever we were sitting watching a screening, and that trailer would come on for American Assassin, I was like, oh, God, and you had a little bit of hope.
Yeah.
When I saw this movie, can you believe this? The movie was even worse than what I thought it was going to be.
Yeah.
I didn't have a high of expectations at all.
It really reaches for a low bar. It really is just sort of like, here is your popcorn. Just, you know, like, we couldn't afford the butter. Just get it into you. Get it in.
Go and see this. Too much salt. Yeah. Too much salt.
Yeah, it's
for this.
It's junk. What are you going to give American Assassin?
I'm going to give it like a 3.5 out of 10.
I'm there. I'm at a 4, I think. I like the couple elements a little bit more. But we've assassinated this movie. Don't go see it. And we know you can make a better movie. And if you are interested in doing that, you know that the VFS School of Film has a 1-year program where they will teach you all kinds of cool things. Go to VFS.edu for more info.